Even as we gain familiarity and access to our participants, their doubts about us and our work may persist. Gaining their trust involves putting these doubts and suspicions to rest. For this, we need to present ourselves in a manner that clearly conveys our place in the context and our reasons for being there. In other words, what is the role and purpose of our presence in their world? We need to be clear about this to ourselves and to our participants. Let's speak about this role and what it entails. What are the responsibilities and relationships that it comes with, and how do we enact it? Some ethnographers recommend that as we begin fieldwork, we take on the role of the professional researcher. This means behaving and conducting ourselves in such a manner that conveys professionalism, dedication, and competence towards the task of research. We may convey such qualities by prioritizing research-related activities and by displaying a keenness to learn about the other. Being professional does not mean that we have to be all serious and business-like. It simply means we have to be committed to learning from our participants. At the same time, it is important to maintain certain principles, like respecting the confidentiality and privacy of our participants. Taking on such a role helps diffuse some concerns about our presence and our intent. So, how do we enact this role? Our physical appearance and social behavior are the most basic aspects of our self-presentation. This includes how we dress, the language we use, our manner of speaking, and so on. The thumb rule is to dress simply, neatly. We should not stand out too much, but we need not try to dress like our participants either. We are often outsiders anyway. Knowing the language of our participants can be a great advantage. While working in Kutch, I spoke to some artists in Sindhi, a language that one of the community was comfortable with. This immediately got us off on the right foot. Why? Because it made interactions more immediate and direct without someone mediating and interpreting. Equally important is how we speak, the ways in which we address people, how we ask for their time, and so on. Here too, knowing the particularities of a culture is important. In some communities in rural India, for example, interacting with someone over the phone more than in person can be seen as a sign of arrogance. As a participant in rural Bihar once told a researcher, someone who wants to talk on the phone without having an in-person meeting comes across as too haughty. On the other hand, in many urban communities, we would be expected to call for an appointment before meeting in person. Just showing up for a meeting would be considered rude even. Through our manner of engaging with participants and their context, we should be able to demonstrate our interests in their world. This involves being open and curious about what we are being exposed to, asking questions about the phenomena that we encounter, listening patiently and without judgment, and adapting to the climate, food, and ways of living to whatever degree possible. Such actions represent our commitment to our research and our willingness to learn from participants. This commitment gives participants a reason to trust us and to work with us. Filmmakers Anjali Montero and K.P. Jaishankar had such an experience while making their film Soheda Sohoda, for which they lived among the pastoral communities of Kutch. The team's commitment to their work and their subject translated into their continued presence in an environment which was unfamiliar and perhaps not all that comfortable. The participants were not oblivious to the efforts of the team and responded by working with the filmmakers, supporting them in their project.
असली तो असल न हो कम हाँ ये भी पैदा थी इंसान जो भरोसा है ना। हाँ अज असी भले गीत गाय न गाय अस पहचान तन में होंद न होंद ये अज अस अज ही भारी अस वाणे तो अस वेही ना सको कम करना हाँ एवर जो गाड़ी उबी आने ये वी आया आला कर करो इनमें भले बाली हुए भले आगे पास के न पास तो मुझे मन में तो अड़ो होंद न जो मुझे रकाटे में थो पो कद ना कद आऊँ ना हूँ तो मुझे छोकर तो सुन ये सच गाल अज जी जी आए ना जी अं करो ती बराबर कर घर तो आजा तो होंगे कमकार तो आके बेहतर तो होंद ना घर अज केतरो टाइम थो अज केतरो टाइम थो इतने फरो जबानी गिनो वा न अस भले खोटी कर हक भी इनके खी दिए अड़ो ना जो अस खोटो खोटो विहारे सिर्फ ना ना अस मत खर्चो कें जात जो खर्चो ना चाहे को फुको डकी डकी अस पियो था
This sequence from Soheda Sohoda shows us that participants are just as observant and curious about us as we are about them. As we learn about them, they learn about us and formulate their analysis just as we do. A moving example of this is to be seen in Judith and David McDougall's film Lorang's Way. The film is based among the Turkana people of Uganda. It speaks about the impeding changes to their ways of life brought about by developments in Uganda after the country's independence from British rule. This narrative is told through conversations with Lorang. Having worked in the army and lived in many different places, Lorang chose to return to the community. And over the years, through hard work and careful planning, he established a large household and family and became the owner of several herds of cattle. In the sequence we are about to see, Lorang speaks to his son, a young man, about the importance of maintaining their herds through hard work. In advising his son, Lorang speaks of the changes occurring among the Turkana and across Uganda. He speaks about the advent of new forms of knowledge such as literacy and the conflict between literacy and traditional forms of wisdom. And into this conversation, he brings his understanding of white folk, people like the filmmakers and researchers recording Lorang's conversation with his son.
Lugo ni ga da go. lua pan tengkala ni ke lu ada har ada har kana ya pan tengkala dang tanya ke ni mun bang amantu gue ni tanya ke ngapa lagi nak buru pak ana ujung orang nak kata lawa ala nu kana aku kau ane ruku di kana ye bare ke ni kana kaya kau nak kena
aku ya ni ngatur gua
ndiru gua
ori ngulu gua mau make ada kan
ngulu kong atur oh gua ngatur gua ni kana ke pana kala ni rada gini dik
roke ka
ngulu kong atur
roke ka ala ni awa tanya ni ngun kan
ngora ka ta jalanannya kok kono
aku nyetu arame nya ke ru kok kala bla bla ame tur na ngona tor putu je nya
ne ma
je ngulu kong atur awuri gini ola ko tonga lu nya ko lugu lu itu dia betul ni nyebo yuri to kena lupuri banga kan to ngalu edi tar teng to ngalu yakil na ya ko det ba ni na bokit be minar ti nyebo yuri to kena ya ko ngabaren ni nyu ni e jamun tal to ma bad mamburi je tamam robodir nyeri ya nang barne ka ngato wana to kona nu nyeri yanang barna kanya kilna tokona ite yong be tingita be nga be tamade nya ite mono ke kurinya ngin nyeri ya au zou che rai nga kro au zou alo kadi dang lo che ba yong na kne kadi ku lo che yun ya tamari ye burenya mi lo che yun ya tamari ayanga kini anna boya kaatu ngulu nyugwa ki yongo nyiborebe nyugwa ki yo nyiborini bebe yo nyugwa ki toma to fubu che yoko nka toko nabu nya kumurda nicha kumurur te de ango tan toko na ango lorang tani e ye che to no kugo na kumoror de che da ta ma di nyo ko lo nge re yo nga to nge ra ke gri nge ra ke gri a ke gri ye ke ra gri bu pa di yo nga ya gur lo be ko na be nga la te tin ta be ba di ba la jo mo ni ya ba la jo mo nya ke gri bu no kai nyo ri na kali ma gri ga ili ni ko ni akro to limu ke temu ke lotala limun ro bjo agro he graken to di de da jo agron na lotat
Lorang develops a keen and complex understanding of his researchers, even as the researchers are trying to develop an understanding of him and his community. This curiosity that participants have about researchers and their research takes varied forms. Sometimes, as with Lorang, it is an analytical one. Other times, it is a simple kind of curiosity. The film Kitchen Stories, directed by Bent Hamer, articulates this in the most accessible way. By actively sharing about ourselves, who we are, where we come from, we address the curiosity that our participants have about us. In doing so, we make ourselves more comprehensible to them and enable them to trust us. By sharing about ourselves, we also try to build a reciprocal relationship where they can learn about us just as we want to learn about them. In all these ways, we try to be more approachable and invite dialogue. And in fact, most participants, even when they are questioning us, are seeking a dialogue. The barrage of questions that the cover makers posed to me was in fact the opening of a dialogue. By asking me all of these questions, they were giving me a chance to introduce myself and my world to them, just as I was inviting them to tell me about theirs. These conversations and engagements are prerequisites for building a relationship where the researcher and the participant are comfortable with each other.